A very good morning, students. Today our topic is conditional and iterative statements, and this is again continuation of Python revision tour. So we'll have a recapitulation of what all we have discussed in the last class. So what did we discuss? Data handling, different types of data, and their importance and how they are used, then implicit conversion, explicit conversion, and also arithmetic operators, different types of operators, right? So that was all we have discussed in the last class. So in this class, now we'll see about conditional and iterative statements. Now before going to this, we'll just see a basic program of simple interest on and compound interest program, which you have did n number of times last year. So why before class only, why not after class? Because I want to show you the difference between a simple statement programs and also compound statement programs. Now I'll tell you the difference also. Now let us see the basic difference, basic program of finding simple interest and compound interest of a particular reading values. Okay, so we'll be needing script mode, so I'll go and open a new file. Okay, so what do we need now? So what is the formula of simple interest and compound interest? First I'll write simple interest P into T into R by 100, right? And for compound interest, P into 1 plus R by 100 power T. Now see here, this double multiplication symbol is nothing but exponent, as you already know, right? So what is the formula for simple interest? It is P into T into R by 100, and for compound interest it is P into 1 plus R by 100 power T. Okay, so what all variables you need here? P, T, R. For here also P and T, R. So we'll read values for P, T, R. Better to use float only always. So P float input, enter principal amount. Right? Now P T equal to, now again float. Why I'm using float? Yesterday we have seen a very important topic of conversions. Now when I give integer type, but when I have my floating type, if I will lose my result value, because precision may be lost. So in order to avoid that, better to use float as your data type. Input, enter time period. Now rate, float input, enter rate of interest. Yeah, so we have done with reading three values, P, T, R. Now we'll write our formula, simple interest, or you can simply write SI your way. Simple interest equal to P into T into R by 100. Okay, now I'm writing compound interest. Why I'm not using space here? You should not use space because it will treat as separate variables. Compound interest equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 power T. Now we are done with our calculation part. Now you have to print it. Print. The simple interest is. In comma, you will write your variable. Now again print. The compound interest is, comma, compound interest, right? So this is our program. Now we have took values for P, T, R, that is nothing but we are reading values for P, T, R, and then we are calculating simple interest P into T into R by 100. Then we are calculating compound interest P into 1 plus R by 100 power T. Then we are printing it. Now I will save my program. So I will write it as interest dot S or else simple interest compound interest SICI by dot pi. Right, save. Now let me check by running it. Okay, enter principal amount, I am writing it as 1000. Time period, I will write it as 2 years, okay. And rate of interest, 5. So, simple interest is 100 and the compound interest is 1102.5. Clear? So, this is your output for simple interest and compound interest, right. So, here, did we use any looping statements? No, right. Any like or else any normal statements like if, else, elif, no, right? So all these are simple statements. They are not using, we are not using any if, else or looping statements or anything, right? So now this is a basic program for all the concepts which we have covered in the previous sessions. Like this you have seen for writing data type float. Input is for reading input values. Input function we have seen in the second tutorial, and PTR, reading values, then calculating it, and print is for printing your output in your console. Clear? So this is the basic program for calculating simple interest and compound interest. Now we will see our today's topic, conditional and iterative statements. Now the topic name itself will tell conditional and iterative statements. Now what do you mean by conditional? If you remember, you can know that if else, elif, all these are conditional statements. Why? Because if a condition is true, that block of statements will be executed. Else, the other block of statements will be executed, right? So that's why they are called conditional statements. And what do you mean by iterative statements? Iterative statements are nothing but iteration means looping, repeating. So when I want my loop to be repeating itself unless and until the condition becomes false. So for example, you want to print 1 to 10 numbers. So instead of writing 10 lines of code again, simply I'll put one iterative condition statement and which will help me to repeat my set of lines of code unless and until the condition becomes false. Clear? That's why it is called iterative statements. So that was a basic overview of the title. So now learning objectives will be types of statements, empty, simple and compound. And the second will be jump statements, break and continue. Again in simple statements and compound statements you will be seeing different types. So we'll start the tutorial or class. Yeah. So types of statements in Python. So Python's statements are instructions given to computer to perform any kind of action, be it a data movements and be it making decisions or be it repeating actions. Just now what we have discussed is given as a statement, right? So what do you mean by statement? statements are instructions given to the computer to perform any kind of action, whether it may be printing simple print statement or using conditional statements or using repeating statements. Okay, so statements form the smallest executable unit within a Python program. We already know this. So types of statements: empty, simple, compound. Now what do you mean by empty statement? Empty statement means a statement which does nothing. In Python, empty statement is a pass statement. It takes a following form. Pass means when you know that your statement has nothing to do with it, you can simply write pass statement to show that it has to do nothing. Okay, that is empty statement. Now what do you mean by simple statement? Simple statements are all the executable statements in a simple program. Like you see here in our program, we'll see. This is a statement. Each and every line of this program is a statement. P, T, R, simple interest, compound interest, print, two print statements. All these are simple statements, like any executable statement in Python. Okay. So for example, he gave it as name equal to input your name. Okay, reading value. He gave an example of simple statement using reading value. And your name will be assigned to name variable. Now, what do you mean by compound statement? Just a second. Yeah, compound statement is nothing but it is a group of statements executed as a unit. The compound statements of Python are written in specific pattern as shown below. Yes, see here, ma. Compound statement header and indented body containing multiple simple and or compound statements. Now, if you don't get confused by seeing this syntax, if you remember, if a divisible by 2 equal to 0, then indentation, it is even number. Okay, if not, it is odd number. Okay, I'll just show you with an example. Okay, this is a compound statement. That is, a compound statement has a header line which begins with a keyword and ends with a colon. This is a must. Like, if is a keyword and colon means that is end of that statement. And after that, you'll have your set of Python statements. Now, shall we see one example? Okay. I'll take one more. Okay, we'll see a program to see if a number is even or odd. Okay, first I'll take one number input. Number equal to int. We should always use int only because even and odd numbers will be divisible by 2. Right, int input enter your number. Then we already took your input value and that is stored in num. If num mod 2 equal to 0 colon. See here, if is a keyword and this is my condition. After this, I'll write my colon. And if I press enter, directly it is taking indentation, that is nothing but 4 spaces. So I'll write my print statement here. Print the given number is even, right? Now, else. Now, why else, ma'am? So, you have already seen if that condition is not true, it will obviously skip that part of code and go to else part. Now, I'll write else. Print the given number is odd. Okay. So, I'll save this as even or dot py. Okay, so after saving this, so am I clear with the program? First reading a value and placing over it to num, and you already know what is division. This is not division, this is modulus. Okay, modulus is nothing but when you divide any number, you should consider its remainder as your answer. It will leave a remainder. So if I'm writing 10, 10 mod 2 will leave remainder as 0 only. So that is this present condition. So I'm running this. So I'll write my number as 15. So what will be my output? The number is odd, right? So because why? It is not 15 mod 2 will leave a remainder 1, right? 2 sevens are 14 and it will leave a remainder 1. So it is not an even number, it is an odd number. We'll check one more example with even number. I'll write it as 14. Okay, the given number is even. So I think you got the difference between these both, right? Yeah, so here we'll see the same example with the syntax. So if that is nothing but compound statement header and that colon and your indentation here, like they have given indented body, and this your print statement. Clear? So this is a basic program to see an example for compound statement, right? So we'll see one more example.